knowing that he was sick, now knowing that he's terminally ill, I think that he has given me things that otherwise I would never know. Basically, as you have put it, spilled it all. And this is why I think they're giving me this information. You're getting the latest. You're getting the update. You're getting what the elite are doing right now, what their this second plans are, and everything that they're going to do from this point on.
Absolutely. Let's go. Let's go right back. We just producing. Absolutely. Let's go to these calls now. Let's talk to Tim in Virginia. Tim, you're on the air with Lindsey Williams. Go ahead.
Lindsey, I heard a lot of different topics you talked about. You touched base about the trade agreement between China and Russia concerning oil. Well, in my opinion, that's one way of the Chinese are hedging their bet against the Middle Eastern conflict. But the same standpoint, Russia is not part of the world economy. They'll export oil and platinum, but as far as Russia's selling oil to China, China is going to have to pay for it in gold or silver. They won't accept the ruble because the ruble's a joke. As far as this NAFTA trade agreement with a common currency in the U.S., that would be totally ludicrous for the U.S. due to the fact that all the drug dealers across the border in Mexico would just love it. Boy, they'd have a common currency, and it would be hard for our federal government and our FBI to trace the funds that these
Hold on a minute, Tim. This is in the news that China and Russia have signed this deal. I want to finish, Tim. It's on record that China is exploring oil and gas, even in Texas. I mean, they're in Africa. They're in the Middle East. They're everywhere. They're in Canada. They're everywhere. And that they're looking for oil and minerals. They're now the biggest extractor of minerals in the world. They're building all the big facilities. They're putting in the mines. Last time I saw, more than half of the mining going on in Australia is the Chinese. And almost all the new startups are Chinese. So all of that is going on. And then we have the North American Union plan. We have Robert Pastor at the CFR's plan. We have the Baylor Agreement with Bush and Fox and Paul Martin at the time 5 years ago. So everything Lindsey was saying on that front, I mean, that's all public. So China is trading raw materials, and they've also got dollars, euros, yuans. I mean, they're flush with cash to buy whatever they want. And these deals with China and Russia are on record. I mean, what are you saying, Tim?
Well, I'm just saying that you don't hear about a proliferation of Chinese imports going to Russia. You don't hear about all these Chinese goods that we have here in the U.S. We don't hear about them in China or in Russia. You know, you don't hear about those goods, the cheap goods that we import from China that are on our stores and our various retail establishments across the country. You don't hear about them inside of Russia.
I mean, Russia is now the biggest oil and gas producer in the world. Just search the term. Russia now the biggest oil and gas producer in the world. It's ABC News. I mean, you name it. I mean, I'm really having trouble getting at what you're saying here, Tim.
What I'm saying is that
value was given to the deal that was made between China and Russia. And the reason no dollar value was given is because the dollar is not going to be used. They'll find their own method of barter and trade or currency, whatever they wish. But the main thing is,
No one can deny.
Russia and not other things.
No one can deny there's a move away from the dollar. I mean, Tim, sum it up. I got to cut you off here in a second, but sum up what you're saying.
What I'm saying is that the Russia could manipulate the U.S. economy any way they can. They can sell gold below market price and make a profit. They could sell it at $600 an ounce.
No, I understand.
And they would still make a profit.
Okay, Tim, I appreciate your call. Jack in Tennessee, you're on the air. Jack, go ahead. Jack dropped off. Kirk in Illinois, go ahead.
Hey there.
Hey.
Hey, I just want to real quickly say that the Money Bomb was the best program to date, man. Your guests are just top-notch, including Lindsey. I'm too bad he wasn't on that program, but I'm glad he's on today. The question I have for Lindsey is, how does the Fed Reserve Act expiring in 2012 figure in? And did your friend recently mention anything about the BP disaster in the Gulf, anything new?
Oh, positively. In fact, whenever you call my 800 number, if you wish to get the CD on the BP disaster in the Gulf of Mexico, it's still there. You can ask them for it. I gave an in-depth, over an hour, hour and a half presentation.
I know, but what I'm asking is, what the caller's asking,
in the Gulf of Mexico.
What the caller's asking, Lindsey, was there anything new that he gave you on that?
Oh, yes, positively. They have been able to fill that pipe with the drill mud, and they have stopped the leak, but that does not take care of the core exit problem. It does not take care of the oil that's already there. This is going to last for years and years and years to come. They have downplayed this. BP has hired every scientist that went down there to investigate it and has put them on their payroll for years to come in order to keep them quiet. This is a disaster of disasters still, but nobody's even talking about it.
Okay, sorry to interrupt you. We got to go to break. I'm going to let Kirk have another question if he wants to on the other side. Then Howard, Blake, Sue, and others. 1-800-259-9231 is the toll-free number to join us. It is Thursday, the 21st day of October, 2010, Infowars.com.
This is not a drill.
Repeat.
This is not a drill.
Gun sales are on a staggering pace.
Gun prices are going through the roof, and that means desperate, vicious criminals now want your guns
and will do anything to get them.
Now, a new book reveals powerful secrets for hiding your guns from thieves and looters. You'll learn step-by-step, battle-hardened techniques, where to hide your guns so criminals will never find them,
how to create the perfect hiding place,
as well as the places you should never hide your guns
under any circumstance.
These and other closely guarded gun-caching secrets are guaranteed to keep your weapons safe and out of sight when the going gets tough.
But listen up.
For security reasons, the Hide Your Guns book and even the website may disappear without warning at any time. Go to hideyourguns.com.
That's hideyourguns.com.
Or call 877-327-0365.
Before they come for your guns.
Hideyourguns.com right now.
Right now.
Good day, Peter Kranchnagel from Midas Resources. Today is October 21st, 2010. Gold opened this morning at 1345.10. A 1 ounce gold coin can be purchased for 1380.16, 690.08 for a half ounce, and 345.04 for a quarter ounce. That's 1380.16, 690.08, and 345.04.
Again, the Congressional Budget Office sounds the alarm, warning of Greek-style U.S. debt crises. CBO is drawing a parallel between U.S. economy and the Greek economic meltdown. Debt to GDP climbing to unfamiliar territory and deficits rising to unsupportable levels. Hi, Ted Anderson. The Federal Debt and Risk of Financial Crises document the CBO has published is a must-read for every American. Covering the risks of deficit spending, aging population, and rising interest rates spells economic disaster. Call today at 800-686-2237. I'll send it free. Again, call 800-686-2237. Ask for the CBO document. Call 800-686-2237.
The question is, where should the American people draw their line in the sand?
What have we got? A republic or a monarchy?
A republic
is based on a constitution which protects minority rights.
It's not democracy, not mob rule, two wolves and a sheep voting on what's for dinner.
So they think they own our land, they think they own our water, children, our education, our money.
We have to define who we are and what we will tolerate.
Somebody's going to ask you what you did during the Patriot Uprising.
You have been warned.
We have the facts. We have the Constitution. We have the Bill of Rights. We have common law. Knowledge is power, ladies and gentlemen. And I'm so excited to be able to offer you, Don't Tread on Me, Rise of the Republic. Tyranny is upon us, but liberty and the sleeping giant that is the American people is rising. A new tool in the info war. Don't Tread on Me. Order it at Infowars.com or PrisonPlanet.com or call toll-free 888-253-3131. And support independent, patriotic, liberty films.
What is a wind generator?
How can the wind produce power for a small cabin?
How can wind energy be stored and used during an emergency?
Can I assemble my own wind generator?
For answers to questions about wind power, visit windbluepower.com. Did you know the wind could provide your family with emergency power? It can with a wind generator from windbluepower.com. Learn how our amazing LightBreeze wind generator kit starts charging a 12-volt battery and just 6 mile per hour wind. Or see the new Cyclone X2 dual kit featuring two wind generators on just one tower. And learn why schools and universities across the country utilize our products to teach about wind power and alternative energy at windbluepower.com. All kits qualify for a 30% IRS tax credit for residential energy efficient property. Enter coupon code RADIO for a 5% discount at windbluepower.com. That's windbluepower.com or call 800-976-0026. That's 800-976-0026.
Okay, I want to go to as many of your calls now as quickly as possible. Please, a question or comment for Lindsey Williams, who's our guest right now. We've got more stuff we need to go over before he leaves. Kirk in Illinois, anything else? Any other questions?
Yeah, I'm glad you held me over. Lindsey, back 1 year and 2 days ago, you were on this program, and you mentioned that oil within the next 2 years was going to be the same, roughly about the same price. Also, you mentioned that war was planned after 2 years. Now you're saying that they're going to bump that up.
If I remember correctly, Lindsey, it's all on record on his DVDs and on this from this radio show. He said, enjoy oil prices. They're not going to go up for at least a year. And go on trips and enjoy yourself, because my source told me after that it's going up. And here we are a year later, it's starting to go up. That's what Lindsey said. Lindsey?
Yes, that's exactly right, Alex. That's what I said. I said it on your program. I recorded it on my DVDs. And now, of course, I am told by this individual that they are ready to bring the price back up to $150 to $200 a barrel. And it'll take place in the near future. You'll see it go back to $4 and $5 a gallon at the gas pump.
Kirk, does that answer your question?
The last one I had was nearly everyone will be a government employee. Could you flesh that out a little more?
Well, he means they're going to control the whole system, so even if you're private sector, you'll be beholden to them and be paying checks one way or another to them. Correct, Lindsey?
Well, let's just take an example, your health care bill. Every doctor, every dentist, every nurse, every hospital, every person that works in the medical profession of any kind will be an employee of the federal government after the health care bill has taken place. That means that every bank is going to likewise, once they bail out this mortgage-backed security problem, every bank, every person that works for a bank, everybody that has a pension fund, you will basically get it from the elite. This is their goal, is to totally control everything. The name of the game is control.
Okay, Kirk, we'll now talk to Howard in Connecticut. Howard, you're on the air. Thanks for holding.
This is Howard.
Yes.
Having been just recently awoken to all this tyranny that's around me, having been blind for so many years, this is like obviously a big overwhelming thing. Considering the direction that we're going in this country, you know, with all of this tyranny and it's coming down very quickly, how does somebody that's recently awakened, such as myself, hedge himself, whose house he purchased for cash here in Connecticut in 2005, that went down, lost work, had to mortgage the house, had to lose money in the stock market. How do I, now that I realize all those traps, how can I better prepare myself for this upcoming tyranny for my family?
Well, you know, it's hard enough to analyze the enemy operations, and then it's even harder to analyze an individual who you don't know calling from Connecticut about what your financial situation is, what your local economy's like. I don't really give people individual financial advice. I tell people what I think's coming, what's going on, what's happening. We have a pretty good track record. But Lindsey, what's your take on that?
My suggestion is, and I'm not being facetious at all, listen to the Alex Jones Show every single day. Don't you dare miss a single program. Everything he's saying is bringing you up to date as of that minute as to what is happening. And the best way you can prepare yourself and believe what you're hearing, because you're not going to hear the truth from the national media. You listen to InfoWars and Alex Jones every day, and over a period of time, you'll be able to prepare yourself.
I mean, Howard, it's very complex. I don't know all your financial issues, and, you know, I know my financial issues that are, you know, not going in the right direction, and, you know, I'm so busy working that I don't really even carry out the decisions that I've made that are most important. I don't know everything, and I'm not omnipresent, so I don't really know what I could say for you to do, Howard. Just, you know, we need to cut taxes. If the globalists cut taxes instead of raising them, that would be the best thing to unstall the economy, and they know that, okay?
Well, if you'd like to make decisions properly, if you want to know what they're going to do so that you can know what to do next, I plead with you, please get my six DVD set. You probably haven't seen it. And the CD that we're producing today of all of this material, plus more that I can't give in an hour and a half, if you'll get these, it'll help you to know what next decision to make.
Well, I mean, knowledge is power. I appreciate your call, Howard. We're going to go to break here in a moment and talk to Blake, Sue, David, Mark, and a few others. We've got to hurry through these calls, Lindsey, and then get to any other facts.